My name is Miguel. I am a master student in the Pontificia Universidad Católica del Perú under supervision of Professor Jorge Guerra. And today I will talk about optical and electrical properties analysis of spatter-Itoh thin field taking into account ground-induced inhomogeneities. So, Itoh are the most intensively studied semiconductor because they show high transmittance in the visible region and low electrical resistance. This low electrical resistivity of Itoh is due to a higher carrier concentration because the Fermi level in the energy band diagram is located above the conduction level. This degeneracy is caused by substitutional tin who occupy indium sites. This effects a distortion of the Bixby structure and allow the formation of oxygen vacancy. These defects, institutional thin and oxygen vacancy, contribute charge carrier in the conduction band and explain the good conductivity. Due to these properties, they are used in display device, but these properties are affected by complicated microstructure creating during the field deposition and post-deposition annealing. Because of this, we prepare Itoh layers at low substrate temperature in order to induce inhomogeneity microstructure and tuning the optical and electrical properties. So, how we fabricate these materials? We prepare Itoh thin fields by radio frequency magnetron sputtering. We substrate cooling active during the deposition process without rotating in order to have various samples with different thickness. Using EDS spectroscopy, we obtain the elemental composition, and we can see in this figure the elemental composition don't change with increasing the thickness. Then thermal annealing is done at different atmospheres such as air or argon in order to modify the optoelectronic properties. First, we need to know how does the microstructure of Itoh behave. In this figure, show the XRD pattern of Itoh thin fields at different annealing temperatures at argon atmosphere, where we can see Itoh as ground present an amorphous structure, and as we increase the annealing temperature, the field is more crystallized. So, we know the first nanometers of thickness of the Itoh field grown in a disordered way, while the following nanometer had a columnar ground as shown in this figure. Due to complicated ground, we separate the Itoh field into two layers. This figure is from this reference. Now, I will show the main result. We measure the optical transmittance to Itoh sample at different annealing temperatures, air and argon. We can see Itoh sample at air atmosphere don't present a change significant in the transmittance in compared with Itoh sample at argon atmosphere. I mean, the transmittance in the infrared region decrease and the edge absorption toward higher energy. Well, these two layers are also known as gradient layer model. Typically, that the electrical function modeling of Itoh is performed by using the Drude model and Tau-Lorentz model, considering only a single layer. But in this study, we model like two layers. Both layers share the same Tau-Lorentz parameters, but different Drude parameters in order to obtain different carrier density and mobility for each layer from transmittance measurement. Now, show the transmittance as a function in the wavelength, where the experiment data is small triangles and the solid line is the transmittance field. The feedbacks obtained by using the previous model, the Drude model, and Tau-Lorentz model, and we found that the behavior or carrier density divided by a constant error for both For both layers, as of the annealing temperature, air is the equal band effect mass divided by mass. For the bottom layer, the blue graphite, the carrier density increases in constant with the top layer, which decreases, and this is due to the structure is being rearranged at the beginning of the temperature, and 150 degrees centigrade begin increasing in both cases. Since the substitution of indium or by tin and the creation of oxygen vacancy may be occurring. So, as the electrical current has a radial behavior, we will take the two layers as they were parallel resistor. In this way, we calculate the electrical resistivity for transmitter measurement and compare with the electrical resistivity measured by Van der Pond technique, as shown in this figure. We can see both resistivity present the same behavior. The low electrical resistivity value was obtained at 500 degrees centigrade. Now, in this figure show the energy, the left figure, and the right figure represent the Urbach energy. Both are as a function of the annealing temperature. They were calculated by using band protection models. We can see in the left figure the widening of energy back gap can be by the boosts. It is related with increasing carrier density. Now, in the right figure, we can also confirm that the Urbach energy is increasing with annealing temperature. So we may expect it. The defects are increasing since the Urbach energy indicate us the disorder degree. The first is a guide to the eye. To summarize this, using cooling active during fabrication on thin films is induced ground on inhomogeneity in microstructure in order to investigate the optical and electrical properties. Then, layers model and optical measurements and determine density and mobility at different annealing temperatures at an argon atmosphere in order to investigate the electrical and optical properties. And that is reflected in the chains of the electrical resistivity. Finally, I want to thank institutions that funding this work: Fondesi, Concitec, Office of Naval Research, and Matter Group. Thanks.